Now let's get to today's feature segment on portfolio positioning and some sector picks with Eddie Gabor, managing partner at Key Advisors Group. It's wonderful to see you, Eddie.
Thank you.
So as I just said earlier, a moment ago, we're looking at record closes for the market. So the question is, do you think the market is overbought at this point, or does it still have room to the upside? One of our guests earlier, Matt Malley from Miller Tabak, was saying that the 10% move is more likely to be to the downside now. What are your thoughts?
Short term, we're definitely overbought. I mean, what a snapback we've had since last Friday, down over 600 points. But my projections going into this year was double-digit returns for 2020. The bottom line is, the hardest thing for investors to do is kind of ignore a lot of the noise that's out there and the volatility and focus on fundamentals. The fundamentals right now are a 10-year note under 2%. We have a very accommodative Fed, and the consumer is extremely strong. As long as our domestic economy stays the way that it is and the consumer stays strong, with the underlying fundamentals that I just explained, sky's the limit this year. I think we're going to look at another double-digit year in the equity markets, in my opinion.
I think we should take note of this day, because that is quite the bullish call. I mean, not one that we get on a regular basis. You did say that at this point you're watching coronavirus. Earlier we had a conversation about Boeing and how it may affect the U.S. economy, big picture. So in the near term, you wouldn't be surprised to see a pullback. Is that the buying opportunity?
I would look at that as a buying opportunity. Of course, you got to look at it from a percentage basis. Frankly, I would have liked to seen a deeper drop versus the 3% drop we've saw from the peak. I was hoping we would get to that 5 to 6% drop level. I think we'll have an opportunity to see that here in the first quarter at some point in time, as some of the coronavirus earnings reports start to maybe get revised. And I look at that as a buying opportunity for investors. There's a lot of cash on the sidelines. Many investors have not participated because they haven't believed in this bull market.
Right. I mean, it's true. There is a lot of cash on the sidelines. So if there's a record year ahead and double-digit growth, that would be super. Where do we put our money? I know you like to watch banks and technology. Explain if those are where we should be putting our money and how to do that.
So I think it's going to be a lot of a repeat of last year, right? Technology has continued to lead the way with growth. I think that's going to continue to be a very bright spot in the market. And then I do like the banks. The banks have really not participated as much in the last 5 years as the tech and the growth area. But the consumer is strong. These banks, large cap banks, when we start to see the virus fears go away, you'll see the 10-year notes start to creep back up, and that fear of an inversion of a yield curve will go away. And that's very profitable for banks. So I like the large banks domestically.
So large banks domestically. What about some of the smaller ones, like the regionals? Would you stay away from those and stick to the big money center banks?
I prefer the bigger banks, because I think they have a better pulse on the overall consumer. And I think stability-wise, I like their profit margins.
Tell me about technology. Within technology, I mean, there's so many areas of technology. What areas do you like more than others?
So I think the semiconductors may be a nice opportunity with some fears with China, right?
Right.
They're going to be impacted because they get some of their revenue from overseas. So when that fear starts to kick in, I think you'll see the semis drop, and I would look at that as a buying opportunity. And then, of course, your FANG stocks, I think they're going to continue to just be leaders in that space.
What about everybody so concerned about the volatility we may see surrounding the election? Are you concerned about volatility around the election?
Absolutely. Now, I think what we've seen so far this year is a preview of what the entire year is going to look like. We got spoiled last year with very little volatility. This year, volatility is here to stay, and that's why I think you need to be cautious when you're jumping in, but always have money on the sidelines to be able to buy the dips. As we get closer to the election and we know who the Democratic candidate is actually going to be, I think that's really what will start the volatility in regards to the election itself.
What do you stay away from?
So right now, what I stay away from are the utilities. They've done really, really well.
And they're right at these highs, I mean, basically, right?
Yeah, so they concern me. Again, buy low, sell high. So I would stay away. That's been the safe trade. And with the fear that's come in with the coronavirus, you have definitely seen that run up. So I would stay away from the utilities right now.
Okay. Eddie Gabor, it's great to see you. Managing partner at Key Advisors Group, for joining us on the show. Thanks
Thank
so
you.
Much.